Welcome back to SolidWorks tutorial. Today we are going to design a simple electric tester design in SolidWorks. So it is basic tutorial for the beginners. I hope you like it. Thanks for watching. And we render this in KeySort 7. So look how we create this model in SolidWorks and render in KeySort. So here we can just see the animate explode for this drawing. So go to the assembly, now select right click and make it animate explode. So it's explode from its position. So look how we create this model in SolidWorks. Now exit this and make it collapse, then OK. Now we design this tester in SolidWorks. So here go to the file, now select new, here select part, then okay, and change the background to plain white. Here we select top plane, so it's better to select top plane. Right click, sketch and normal. Here we select the circle and make the circle from this origin point. Go to the smart dimension and make it 40 diameter. Now go to the feature, select extrude boss base, and here we extrude this one up to 110 mm, so make it, then OK. Again we select the right plane, sketch, then normal. Here we select the center line and make the center line from this point up to here. Now go to the line and make the line from this point to this one. Again select and join to this line. Now go to the smart dimension. This length will be 3.5 mm and this one also 3.5. now we make this sketch revolve cut. So go to the feature, select revolve cut, and we select this center line, then OK. Now again select this face, right click, sketch and normal. Here we select the center line, so select and make the center line up to this one. Now exit the sketch. Here we go to the circle and make the circle from this point up to here. Now go to the smart dimension, it will be 7 diameter. Now again select the circle and make the circle up to here and make sure it is tangent to this circle. Now go to the trim and trim this portion. Again delete this also. Here we extrude this feature, so go to the features and select the extrude cut. Here we make it offset of 30 mm, so make it offset, and here we select the reverse direction and we make it up to, then OK. Now here we make the circular pattern of this cutout. So go to the circular pattern, here we select. Now it will ask parameter, so simply select any circular profile, and here we select the feature and faces. So select this extrude cut and we make the number of pattern will be 8 number of then ok. Now we apply the fillet on this extrude cut. So go to the fillet and make the fillet of 1 mm, and select this face select all this face separately . Now we apply the fillet to all this extrude cut. So again select this face, right click, sketch, then normal, and here we make the circle. So go to the circle and make the circle up to here, and go to the smart dimension. This length will be 39 diameter, and here we make the extrude up to this sketch of 15 mm. So go to the feature, select extrude boss base and extrude up to 15 mm and make the condition merge, then ok. Again we select this face, right click, sketch, then normal. Here we select the circle and make the circle up to this one. Now go to the smart dimension, it will be 30 diameter. Again go to the feature, select extrude boss base and make the extrude this one also 15 mm. Again select this face, right click, sketch, then normal. Here we make the circle of 40 diameter from this origin point. So make it, go to the smart dimension and make it 40 diameter and extrude up to 25. So go to the feature, select extrude boss base and make it 25 mm. Now here we make the extrude cut on this face. So here we select the extrude cut, this portion, and make it so. So it will be C, and again select this face, right click, sketch, then ok. Now here go to the convert entity and select this sketch and make it convert on this face, and go to the features, select extrude cut and make the extrude cut through all. And here we make the also pattern of 8 number of pattern, circular pattern. So go to the circular pattern and here we select parameter. So simply select any circular and select this cutout, and number of intensity will be 8. So first of all we make this revolve cut on it. So go to the right plane, sketch, Now here select center line. Select line and make the line from this. Go to the smart dimension and make it 3.5 mm. Again select this line and make it also 3.5. Now mirror this sketch, so go to the mirror and mirror about this center line. Now here go to the feature, select revolve cut and make the revolve cut on this center line. Again go to the extrude cut and here we select this and make it condition through all, then OK. Now here we make the number of pattern, circular pattern, so go to the pattern, select circular and here we select the parameters, so simply select this and go to the features and faces. So here we select extrude cut and make the pattern will be 8 numbers. Here we apply the fillet, so go to the fillet and make the fillet of 0.5 mm. So we make the fillet of 1 mm here. Again go to the fillet and make the fillet on this face. This one, again select the fillet and make the fillet of 2 mm. Select this one. And this, so select separately. Now again select this also. again go to the fillet, and here we also make the fillet of this edge of 1 mm. And make the fillet of 2 mm on this edge. Now select this face, right click sketch, and here we make the circle. Go to the smart dimension, this will be 32 diameter, and make the extrude cut this one up to 85 mm. So go to the feature, select extrude cut and make it 85. Then okay. Now here we select this face, right click sketch, then normal, and select the circle and make it circle here of 13 diameter, and extrude up to 65 mm. So go to the feature, select extrude boss base, and make it 65 mm. Then okay. Now again select this face, right click sketch, then normal, and here we select the circle and make the circle of 10 diameter. So go to the smart dimension, this will be 10, and make the extrude cut this one through all, now we apply the thread here. So go to the here, go to the hole wizard and select the thread. Now it will ask thread location, so select this one, this edge, and the length of the thread will be 25, and size will be SP4 1 point into M6. Now here we make the chamfer inside, so go to the chamfer and make the chamfer of 3 mm, and select this edge, then okay. Now here we make the fillet of 1 mm, this edge, so go to the fillet and make the fillet of 1 mm, and select this, then okay. Now we apply the material, so go to the appearance, select plastic, select high gloss, and apply to this body. Now select this face, right click sketch, then normal, here we select the circle and make the circle up to this one. Now go to the smart dimension and make it 10 mm. Here we make the extrude this feature, so go to the feature, select extrude boss base, and the direction one will be 90 mm. And direction to inside, make it 155. Then okay. So here we make this extrude and make the condition unmerge. देन ओके। नाउ हेयर सेलेक्ट राइट प्लेन, स्केच, देन नॉर्मल, एंड हेयर वी सेलेक्ट द सेंटर लाइन एंड मेक द सेंटर लाइन फ्रॉम दिस ओरिजिन दिस पॉइंट। नाउ गो टू द थ्री पॉइंट आर्क एंड मेक द आर्क फ्रॉम हेयर एंड अप टू दिस वन। नाउ गो टू द स्मार्ट डायमेंशन, सेलेक्ट दिस पॉइंट एंड दिस पॉइंट, द गैप विल बी 1 mm एंड दिस आर्क रेडियस विल बी 75 एंड फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट एंड दिस पॉइंट द गैप विल बी 26 mm। नाउ सेलेक्ट द लाइन एंड फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू मेक अप टू दिस वन दिस पॉइंट एंड सेलेक्ट दिस वन। नाउ मेक द एक्सट्रूड कट दिस पोर्शन, सो गो टू द फीचर, सेलेक्ट एक्सट्रूड कट एंड मेक इट थ्रू ऑल। Now we make the mirror here, so go to the mirror features and select the plane, so select right plane, sorry right plane not, we select front plane and here we make the features to mirror, so select this extrude cut, then okay. Now here we apply the material, so go to the metal, here we select zinc and select the brush zinc and drag up to this body, select this boss extrude. So make it transparent. Here we design the first part of this. Now go to the file and make it save. And here we select new folder and name it. Now save as. Now we design the second part, so go to the file, select new, here select part, then ok. And change the background to plain white, so select top plane, right click, sketch, then normal. Here we select the circle and make the circle from this origin point. So go to the smart dimension and make it 30 diameter and make the extrude up to 25 mm. So go to the features, select extrude boss base and extrude up to 25, then ok. Now here we make the thread. So go to the thread command. Here we select the thread location and make the thread. So make the condition up to selection and select this face. Then here we make it extrude thread, then OK. Now we remove this extra portion. So select this face, right click, sketch, then normal. Here we select the circle and make the circle up from this origin point up to here. Go to the feature, select extrude cut and make it reverse direction, then OK. Now here we select this face, right click, sketch, then normal, and here we make the circle from this. So select this origin point, go to the smart dimension and make it 43 diameter. Go to the feature, select extrude boss base and extrude up to 3 mm, then OK. Again select this face, right click, sketch, then normal, and here we go to the polygon and select this and make it up to this one. Now again select the circle and make the circle up to here and make sure it is tangent. Now go to the feature, select extrude cut. Here we select this separately, all these corners. Then OK. Now again select this face, right click, sketch, then normal, and here we select the center line up to this one and make the rectangle here. So go to the rectangle and select center rectangle, and from this point this and make up to here. Now go to the smart dimension, this length will be 8 mm and this length will be 2 mm, and make the extrude up to only 6 mm. Again select this face, right click, sketch, then normal. Here we select corner rectangle and make up to here. Now select this line, press with shift key and this line and make the relation collinear, then OK. And the length will be 65 mm, so go to the smart dimension and make it 65, Here we make the extrude only 2 mm inside. So go to the feature, select extrude boss base and up to 2 mm and make the condition reverse direction. And here we make the fillet of 4 mm. So go to the fillet and make the fillet of 4 mm. Again select this sketch, then normal. Again select the line, go to the smart dimension from this one. And this line, the gap will be 2 mm. And select this line and this one, the angle will be 160 degree. And select this point and this point, the gap will be 5 points. Now extrude cut this feature, so select, then OK. Select this edge and this edge, then OK. And again we make the fillet to this edge, so go to the fillet and select this edge also, this one, this. And this one, and make the fillet of 2 mm. So select fillet and make it 2 mm, and select this corners, so it will be big, make it 0.5 to better. So we apply the fillet all here. Now again select fillet and make the fillet of 1 mm, and select this and this also. Now select this face, right click, sketch, then normal. Here we select the circle and make the circle from this point. Go to the smart dimension and make it 3 diameter. Features, go to the feature, select extrude cut and make it through all, then OK. Now here we apply the material, so go to the appearance and here we select metal zinc and select this one and drag to this body. Now we save this one and name it cap. Now go to the file, select new and make it assemble. Select part 1 . Now again go to the insert component and select the part 2 . Here go to the mate, select this circular and this circular body. And make the relation concentric and make it reverse. Then OK. Now here select this face and select this face. Then OK. Now we design this simple electric tester design in SolidWorks, and if you want to make it render in SolidWorks, so here go to the render tool. Now here select the final render and here select continue without camera and perspective. So it takes time to render. So look how we create this simple electric tester in SolidWorks, and we also render this one in KeyShot 7. So look here, so it looks very beautiful. So we design this simple electric tester in SolidWorks. Please subscribe our channel for more video and project. Thanks for watching.